Hey, this is the Swedish Guitar Nerd, and today I'm reviewing a IKEA guitar, as I call it, the Harley Benton T-style guitar kit. So it didn't look like this when I got it, and you can watch my unboxing and build video if you want to see what it was like in the package. But I'm gonna do a review of it when I have put it together and just give you an idea of what it is and how good it is or bad it is. Okay, so let's start. Materials and hardware. We have a maple neck and brown maple for the fretboard, or rose acer treated maple to make it look like rosewood. And rather solid. I mean, Harley Benton makes pretty good tuners, actually. These ones, the proper ones. And yeah, nothing fancy or strange. We have I don't know, not the medium jumbo, maybe a slightly smaller version of the frets here. They're kind of high but not as wide, so it's not jumbo. And yeah, suits the guitar, I think. The fretboard is not super, I don't know, there are some flaws in the wood, and yeah, it's kind of broken down here, but well, it's not on the actual fretboard. The body is basswood, a few pieces, and yeah, it's very light, super light actually, and it's very soft as well, so I've already made a few marks on it, and there probably were some when it arrived too, so yeah. That's the thing with light woods, you get this. It's the same with my Swamp Ash guitar that I had before. Really light, really soft. You dent it really easy. And yeah. It's not finished, of course. It's a kit, so you're supposed to finish it yourself. And protect the wood. Single ply, super white pickguard. Yeah. The cheapest Telecaster bridge you can find. Three saddles. Top mounted strings, and this is turned upside down, so this is the thing I switch. This is the volume, this is the tone, and I will change it when it's getting ready. And then we have the output jack, solid metal, so there, that's nice. Yeah, it's a Telecaster, what can you say? It's kind of bulky, but yeah, Telecasters are bulky, no softed rounded edges. Materials and hardware, I give it a 7. It's nothing super fancy, but yeah, it's working at least. Build quality, durability. Well, since I built it, it's of course master built and super exclusive and everything's perfect, but yeah, let's talk about how the parts themselves were actually put together. I have nothing to say about the tuners. I think they're good. The neck, on the back of the neck, I think it's really good. The front, the fretboard, I talked about the unevenness of the material itself. You can see it in some places. The frets are slightly rough on the edges, and they are very rough on top of them. Actually, when I played this for a while, well, the roughness has gone away, so I guess it was mostly dirt. But yeah, it could use some polishing. The fret ends, and I mentioned this in the unboxing video, are rolled. And that's very, very strange. And something you'd find on a, I don't know, high grade American made guitar. So they are actually, it's not, they aren't, there are no sharp edges on the actual wood. It's actually been rolled off, so it's really soft. Very strange, especially since the edges of the frets themselves aren't perfect in any way. So it's a confusing neck, what can I say? The fit between the neck and the body was really good. If you pause my video, it's going really fast where I do this. But when I put the neck and the body together, I can actually lift the body without any screws attached to the neck. And that's a good sign. That's the way a bolt-on guitar should be built. The only complaint that you can't really see now, because the scratch plate is covering it, it's that the cavity for the neck is perfect on the sides and on the back, but it's not, it's actually goes a bit too far down, and it's not even at all. It's not even. But yeah, you cover it up so you can't see it. And well, the neck manages to get where it's supposed to be anyway. It doesn't affect anything, so. But yeah, it's a flaw, of course. The body, yeah, as I said, it had dents when it came. Now I'm not sure which ones were actually from the package or which I made myself. It's really soft, so if you touch it, you dent it. And that's why, you, I mean, someone would probably want to keep it natural. And then you have to deal with that, because you'll dent it, you'll make marks in it. Maybe you think that's really nice and fine, but I don't know. It won't relic in a nice way. And yeah, it's of course not super, it needs some sanding, and yeah. And that's what they state on the homepage, so that's what you should expect. And you can actually see the wood filler. It's whiter in some places. But the wood itself, it's basswood, and it's really good because it's really super even. No pores. And it's very, very flat surface. It's really good to work with, actually. And it's so light. And that's a really good thing, I think. The scratch plate. And here we are. Harley Benton Telecaster guitars and scratch plates. It's offset compared to the bridge. And the bridge is in the right position, because it's really right where it should be compared to the neck and everything. So I'm, that's the position of the bridge. Perfect. But as you can see, it's tight here, not so tight on this side, and the hole here for the control plate is in the wrong place, which makes you have to attach the control plate so that there's a, you can actually see the cavity here. It's supposed to be, now, because now it's angled, basically, because it's supposed to be a bit more upside. Both of these are cutouts are in the wrong place. They should be further up. And yeah, I've had this before with Harley Benton scratch plates. They were not matching the body. It's hard to tell if it's the body or if it's the scratch plate, but I think it's the scratch plate in this case. Because, yeah, it follows the body otherwise. I think of these cutouts, they're all in the wrong place. The volume and tone and three-way switch are the cheapest you can find, but they are actually working. I should give them that, and I get back to the electronics later. And as I said, the output jack is solid metal, not that you would find on a, I don't know, Les Paul, or for that matter, the Squire Telecaster, Affinity One. That's plastic. So this is much more solid. So, and well, it's a Telecaster. You can, besides denting the body, it will outlast anything, I think. So, yeah. Durability and build quality gives a 7. Gets a 7. Playability. Well, the neck is, I think, a slightly smaller, or at least not as thick in this direction as the TE20 that I thought had a really substantial neck. This is much more closer to a modern. It's not slim. It's still a a piece of wood, you know, but yeah, it's slimmer. And I really like this profile. I really do. I really love playing this guitar. The neck feels really great. So, yeah. But then again, you have these things like the edges aren't, or the frets aren't perfect. And you have this bridge where the height adjustment screws are really high. Because, yeah, that's what you get. It's a common thing. And they are really sharp, and that's not a nice thing when you're playing. So there are two ways to get around this. It's to shim the neck so you get a more, get some angle of it, and then you can raise the saddles. But yeah, another way is to actually file down the saddles so that they are shorter. I'm going to replace everything anyway, so I don't mind. But since you get scratches on both your hands from playing it, it gets a 7. But the neck feels really great. So we have a good potential with this guitar. Playing-wise, I love playing it, actually. Electronics. Yeah, we have the cheapest components you can find. The cheapest pickups you can find, the cheapest controls, and the three-way switch. And it's super noisy. It's so noisy. And I mean, they work. So I can't give it a 0. They actually work and they make sounds. You get to hear it soon. But yeah, you can tell. It's really cheap. And so because of that, it gets a 5 for electronics. Okay, let's hear it then. See what it can do. Okay, I'm gonna start with a clean sound and go through all the pickup combinations and maybe twist the tone knob a bit so you can hear how it works. It actually, it's kind of strange because it works kind of good compared to other cheap guitars, but it works in the range. So in the beginning it's kind of good, and then at the end it gets too much. So. But since it's working all the way, I can't really say that it's as bad as everything else. But now it's on full and everything is on full. And here's the bridge pickup in a clean sound. Thank you. Yep, let's add some overdrive. And finally, a high gain sound with some delay. I think the pickup sound, again, kind of cheap and super noisy, and the difference between the bridge and the neck pickup is extreme, and maybe that's something you want from a Telecaster. I don't know, I'm not a tele player usually, but I don't find it to be a good thing. So the bridge pickup is has much more output than the neck pickup, and it's much more brighter and has more mid-range than the neck pickup that's really muddy and low output, so gets a six. They work, but it's not a sound I like. Actually, I think the pickups on the TE20 were really rather good. And I think there's a difference between them and this one from Harley Benton. So, value. This guitar costs nothing. And building it yourself takes no time at all. If you watch my video, I did a lot of mistakes and redid a lot of things, and it still was like in half an hour. And there are some things to be said. As I said, the bridge is in the right position. The saddles were in the right position for intonation for, yeah, as you installed it, basically. So that was kind of neat. And yeah, it has all the potential of becoming a good guitar. And I think that's one of the, I don't know, the beauty of these kits, that you're buying something that's not finished. You're supposed to make it something else, I think. Or keep it this way if you like it, but it's a very good thing to start with. And start I will. I will upgrade basically everything but the wood. So, and yeah, you'll get to see that in other videos. So, value, I give it a 9. It's not, even if it costs nothing, it's not, yeah, some parts are kind of bad. So, can't give it a 10. All in all, it gets a 6.8. It's not super high, but it's not a super good guitar either. So, we'll see. I'll make it a super good, or at least try to make it a super good guitar. We'll see how that goes in some other videos. So, hope you found this useful. See you soon. Bye.